Sup, Omega? We getting going, buddy. I'm gonna let some music play, and we'll get in here. Yes, sir. I'm trying to get everybody in here. Damn, Omega, pushing it. Hell yeah, bro. Thank you. Forgot emojis. Oh. Welcome to the first episode of Thursday Night Carnage. I've been so excited about this. We've been building it to it for a long, long time. I know everybody's not just now getting in here. I know it's just Omega right now, but we'll get everybody in here as we keep going. All right, so a couple things. As this goes on, I'll be coming back to this screen right here after every segment. That way I can talk to you guys for a little bit and not just going over stories. Also, when you see a promo come on to the stream, I'm going to talk that promo as I would, because the promos on WWE 2K20 are kind of ass. And honestly, y'all deserve better than that. Like, I don't want to read all their content. It's so bad. It's really bad. So we're going to go over our own stuff. So the opening match is going to be for the World Tag Team Championships between FTR, or The Revival, versus the self-proclaimed World's Greatest Tag Team, Charlie Haas and Shelton Benjamin, or formerly known as Team Angle. I think it's going to be a killer show. Of course, in the main event, we have Bret Hart versus Shawn Michaels versus Kurt Angle for the World Championship, and I think that's going to be a banger. What is up, Pesto? So, we have a banger card for you tonight. Also, after the Tag Team Championships, we have the Hardcore Championship that I mentioned on stream, which is going to be between Jon Moxley, Raven, Rhino, and Rob Van Dam in an Extreme Rules match. So we've got banger matches throughout the card. You're also going to hear from MJF tonight. So a lot of good stuff going down. So without further ado, let's go ahead and start this show. Yo, what is up, Madden King? Welcome to Thursday Night Carnage. My music ready for when this starts. That being said, there's the arena, fireworks, the pyro.
There is a reason this program has been a staple of Monday nights for over 25 years. It is entertainment. It is excitement. It is Monday Night Raw.
Without question, one of the most anticipated episodes of Monday Night Raw in the history of WWE.
All right, here we go. All right. You may have seen some of that card. Shh. All right. So this first match, I will not be playing. Yeah, shh. That's very quick. Happened really fast, honestly. I didn't know it was going to do that. Yo, oh, I see the Joker, Kenny Omega. That's pretty awesome. So this one I'm not going to play. I'm going to be playing some of the other matches because they're important to stories. This one, I don't care who wins. And so I learned from Omega stream, the music doesn't play. So I brought my own music.
Scheduled for one fall. 84 knee turn.
the Revival, FTR. I'm excited for this tag team, man. I think they are going to be really hot on the show. They're ready. They're ready. The world's greatest tag team, Shelton Benjamin and Charlie Haas. Let's get it, y'all. Like, just super awesome tag team, very decorated, with the chance to really take over this tag division. Charlie's a little overexcited there. Could be, man. It really could be. Just a lot of talent in this ring. All right, y'all, let's get this match underway. Let's see who walks out with these tag titles here. And there you are, the Twitch World Tag Team Championships. Wow, that looked really dark on that screen. There you go. There's the gold. There's the gold.
Believe me when I say, these titles are in the sights of some top duos.
Oh man, this is one of those matches I would just love to see with both these guys, all these guys being in the primes. Shelton, once in a lifetime talent. Thank you for the follow. Is it Ali? Thank you for the follow.
If you meant anyone but you.
Oh, putting Shelton in the corner.
Oh my God.
Little backbreaker.
TikTok.
So far, FTR is dominating this matchup a little bit on Shelton. Quick jabs.
Right. Yeah, that's some attitude behind it.
Oh, talking some smack here. But Dawson is not scared.
The ability to win a title, to take the championship home.
Wheeler getting involved already.
Tonight.
Oof. Strong elbow strike.
Dawson making him pay. And again, yet another counter. To the midsection.
So, what are some matches on this card, like on the roster, that you guys would like to see down the stretch?
Good luck breathing after that.
Uh-oh, powerbomb. Dawson's not looking too hot.
It's no secret that quick tags lead
dragging
to success
him over to his corner.
In the tag team division. And I'd say
Ooh.
The quicker he can make that tag,
nice counter, Dawson.
The better their chances of winning.
Yo, thank you for the host, Pesto. Appreciate it, buddy. Ready to get some Pesto vibes back.
He's hurting now. If he doesn't get out of that corner, he's going to be hurting even worse.
Oh, Omega, that is on the list. That is on the list. I've got to figure out a way to book that because we all want to see that kick. Yo, thank you for the host, Omega. But we all want
to
see that kick.
Easy though, Michael. No, he doesn't get to his partner. That could
like,
be the difference
one of the
right
very
there.
First wrestling gifts that ever made it to like mainstream was that super kick on Shelton Benjamin. Back when gifts first started. Haas versus Angle. Never really got to see that one, but Haas is really underrated in the ring with one of the most aggressive finishers in the Haas of Pain. Like, I'm sorry, I ever get put in that, I'm tapping out immediately. Shelton's trying to get the tag to Haas. Ooh, the jumping knee strike.
Lot
of talent in this ring. And we hired the best world-class referees for this show. We are the A show. We have the best wrestling on the planet. Looks like we're going to get a hot tag while Shelton's distracted. Here comes Dash Wilder.
To his corner and make the tag. Hoping to make a tag here. It sounds like there are a lot of people here tonight hoping for the exact
pretty sure in real life FTR look in a lot better shape now than these guys do right now. They got some meat on them right now.
That was a game changer right there, Michael. Check out Dash Wilder's offense.
Oof. Hey, you will see, man. This is the A show. This is the dominant brand. All right, man, he is loving this hold. Just three times in a row, just knuckles to the freaking skull. Like, I can't imagine how that feels. Sure, it's not good.
He caught him slipping.
Oh, nice little suplex there. Shelton not looking good. He really needs to make a tag to Haas.
Completely agree. Getting the partner in here is absolutely vital. Missed the tag.
And FTR showing their experience, showing how that they've been in the ring together for a while, looking like true veterans in the ring.
What a tag team match this has been. And gentlemen, Shelton Benjamin may be fading away here.
Oh, taking out Shelton's knees. Absolutely helpless. This is not good. The only thing not
he can
good.
Do is stand there and watch his guy get completely.
That could be it.
Could this be it? One, two, and we got a kick out.
How in the world did he kick out of that?
Not quite.
Oh, Shelton is not looking good at all, man. He really, really needs to get out of here. But FTR have had the experience. They've teamed together more recently. And Haas and Benjamin haven't teamed in years. Like, they really got to get together.
Oh,
double underhook. Oh, Tiger Bomb.
Really needs to get to the corner and make a tag.
Oh, he's looking. Dawson's marking him. But could we see a hot tag?
He's almost there.
Here comes Haas.
He doesn't make the tag. They're in big trouble here, Cole.
The drop kick. Such an underrated talent in Charlie Haas. Here we go.
A quick reversal by Dawson.
Quickly out of that. Haas has got to get together. He's looking a little rusty. Oh, forearm straight. Do not pull your punches, Haas. Here we go.
Power from the suplex.
Haas has got to get that rust off if he wants to have any chance in this match. Oh, dirty tactics from FTR.
Devastating help.
Oh, no, arm breaker.
Submission move. Oh, what agility. The arm bar is locked in. He's just about
but
there.
Cash breaks it up. Dash. Call him by any name you want. Oh.
Not many like that.
Wow, he must have been watching some tape on Tyler Bate. That was a nice rolling kick.
I can't say I expected to see this tonight. It's not every day you see a guy as talented as him take such a beating.
Ooh. Here he goes for the win. Then he closes it out.
Oh, and he barely kicks out. Barely kicks out. Haas has a finisher, so we can see the end at any time. But Dawson's got three. Uh-oh, we got suplexes.
Butterfly suplex.
Here we go. Haas is calling for the end of the match. Could we see the Haas of Pain?
Now in full control.
Oh, bridging suplex. Haas is feeling it. Another arm break. Another arm bar.
Just getting all twisted up. Battling to get
Dash has got
to
break it up. Oh, he took out the ref. He took out the ref. Oh, man, he's working that arm.
Attacking the arm. Great way to break down your opponent.
Dawson, a veteran. Here comes Dash Wilder. He has not been touched this entire match. But it looks like Haas is trying to change that.
Here we go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Ten big punches in the corner.
Looking for the quick pin.
I don't think that's going to do it, Haas. I really don't.
Very curious move to go for a pinfall at this point. Not yet.
Been a fairly good opening bout so far. Who do you think is going to win this match, guys? We still favor in World's Greatest Tag Team? Oof.
Monkey flip. Struggling to get to the corner here.
Might not make it, Michael.
Stopped dead in his tracks.
Oh, so close, Michael.
Oof. Butterfly suplex. Dash is getting beat down. Charlie has taken over this match. I think so, Omega. The way Charlie is taking over this match, man, it does look like it's in their favor.
The beauty of tag team competition is that he doesn't need to take the entire brunt of the opposition's attack, though the thought of making a tag doesn't necessarily appear to be on his mind right now.
Oof.
Wilder connecting with a solid shot.
That was rough.
Finds a way to reverse.
Waiting on that big moment. Oh, God. O'Connor roll.
Into the buckle.
Big suplex. Oh, one, two. Oh, that was close. It was really close.
Things just went from bad to worse for Dash Wilder.
And here comes Shelton Benjamin coming to finish off Wilder. Oh, whoa, he's just swinging Wilder that super kick. Oh, come on, man. He can't get that kick down. That's just 2K20 for you.
Ooh,
there it is.
What should Dash Wilder's mindset be at this point? This is not the time to be a hero. To keep this match from slipping away.
Could this be it? One. Two.
And
two.
Kicks out again. Wilder's not going to be slowed down by a feeble move like that. Tagged in.
Oh, here comes Charlie again.
Kick to the gut.
Oof.
Ooh, bullseye.
Nice little drop kick there.
Athleticism.
All right, so the next match, letting y'all know, is going to be for the Hardcore Championship. Rob Van Dam, Rhino, Raven, and John Moxley. Thank you for the alert, T-Flint. It's going really well, man. It's the first episode. All right, man. Definitely put the kids to bed. Understandable. Ooh, nice chop.
Oof.
Oof.
Painful attack focused on the chest. Stomping. Ouch. He is just reeling.
They're bringing out the aggression now.
The abuse.
Let's see if they can get the job done, though.
This match is a little disturbing. I don't know why he hasn't made the tag yet. It's almost like he enjoys the pain.
Oof. Nice little uppercut there.
European uppercut. Boom. Did you hear the impact? Dash Wilder systematically dissecting. Nothing is going to stop him now.
I think he's a little tired. He's trying to stay in it. Wilder's going for the finish.
Him.
Oh, code breaker.
Dash Wilder.
This could be it, but there was a little hesitation. One, two. Oh, just barely. Shelton breaks it up. But Wilder's not stopping. Wilder's not stopping. He's got Haas. And another. Oh, no, no, no. Haas reverses. Oh, he's going beast mode.
He got out of the way.
Here we go. Suplex.
Beautiful suplex.
Hey, me too, Omega. Me too, man. I think it's going to be a banger. Oh, another suplex. Oh.
Suplex.
Come on, Haas. You got to put him away. Put him into the corner.
Oh, and a terrific reversal.
Oh, see, Haas, you should have put him away.
Complete dominance. Absolutely.
Oh, we got a hot tag.
Here.
Coming in, hot tag.
Almost just a
oh.
Come on now.
Jumping clothesline.
And he gets to his partner. We've got a
no.
Whoa, it's
oh.
Benjamin
nice kick. Shelton's got to put him away.
Nasty.
Oh, too much tot in Shelton. Hey, Omega, I'm excited for Monday, man.
We're going to make the tag here.
A tag at this point can change the whole complexion of this match, Michael.
And see, all that taunting. You see what it does. Boom.
The final cut. Perfectly executed.
See, more taunting. Guys, it hasn't worked out at all match.
You've
got to put somebody away.
Bang, right in the face.
Oof. Knife edge chop. And then jabs. Jabs to the body.
Oof. Nasty left hook.
I'm starting to think this has become more of a personal feud. These guys are just not wanting to put each other away. Here we are, back to the fist to the noggin there.
Boom, what impact.
Come on, Wilder, put him away.
Dash Wilder is moving the momentum to his corner. Man, Wilder is feeling it right here.
Ah, fireman's carry.
Up. Oh, nice little backbreaker.
That looks familiar.
Oh, goes for the pin. Got a pin. Here we go. One, two. Oh, and FTR get the win. FTR get the win. Oh, and beating him down after the match. It's going to be a personal feud. Attacking Shelton after the match. Yeah. All right, here we go. Back to the cam. All right, so what are we thinking of the show so far on the opening match? We having fun? We enjoying ourselves? Because the next match, we've got that hardcore title match, and I think it's going to be good. I think it's going to be really good. I'm going to go ahead. We're about to jump into that hardcore title match right now. Four and a half star match. All right. Solid. Hold on, guys. We're having some issues backstage. Something's going on backstage, and I think it's going to affect our hardcore title match. Apparently, Jon Moxley is getting into an altercation backstage. So we're about to tune in and check and see what's going on with that. Hopefully John's okay. All right.
Good thing we got the big screens out in the arena so that the WWE can see.
Oh, so they've already fought out here to the, in front of the ring. Kane and Jon Moxley just getting into it.
Then these two dislike each other extremely intensely, in case you couldn't tell.
Somebody's got to do something before somebody gets seriously injured back there.
Saxton, you're a sissy.
They get dangerous out here, especially when there are no countouts.
John Moxley and Kane getting into it out here.
Now trampling the opposition. Had it scouted. Oh, bulldog.
One-handed.
Reverses. Can he make him pay?
Oh. They've already destroyed the ringside. Look at that. Look at the damage already been done.
Whack. Michael, that gives new meaning to have a seat.
That connected. I think that was harder than the first time, Cole.
They're fighting all over this freaking area. Bang. Here. Oof. Into the steps. Hardcore, baby.
He's out there in no man's land.
Yeah, he's got to find a way to get to safety, Cole.
I'm not sure he can.
Oh, my God, a clothesline. Again.
Hey, it seems to be working for him.
By God, it's Kane. Yo, what is up, Dintask?
Oh, shows no mercy.
In that poor chair. It looks like a twisted heap.
Oh.
Oh, no, choke slam. Oh, on the freaking chair. Kane's walking off. I think he's just done with Moxley here. Oh.
DDT.
Apparently can't exit backstage. All right. Yo, what is up, Token? Oh, man, another choke slam.
Here it comes. Looking for a choke slam.
No. Oh, Kane is just destroying Moxley here.
Oh, look at that. Scoop slam.
Yo, what is up, DNA? Nice of you to stop in. Oh, Moxley looks destroyed.
Tilt-a-whirl
backbreaker. Oh, little scoop slam. Kane is just destroying this man.
He's in full control now.
John Moxley never had a chance. He's supposed to have a hardcore title match. Just going behind the screen. Oh. Yes, sir. All right, no worries, Chocolate. Come on, Moxley. Get back into this fight here. Moxley's still dazed.
What do we got here? Power slam.
And he's right there by that screen. He's right there by the screen. Oh, man. Not a choke. Oh, he reversed it. He reversed it.
Great counter. Impressive in-ring IQ on display. Caught him with a big boot.
On the mark.
There's a classic sidewalk slam by Kane. And a choke slam. Oh, man. I don't think Moxley's going to be able to compete in the next match. I really don't. Hey, the sound alerts are not working yet. Noise, I do appreciate it, though. All right, man. So it looks like Moxley's not going to be able to compete in the next match. So we know Raven, Rhino, and RVD are going to compete in the next match, but I don't know if they found a replacement or if it's just going to be a triple threat. I don't know if he's injured, but he's not going to be able to compete tonight. So we're going to get into this next match here in just a second. Letting it load. Get my music ready. So it should be an interesting contest to see if it's a triple threat or they just found a replacement for this match. So far, I mean, we're only in, what, going into match number three? We're killing it tonight, man. I feel comfortable. And then after this match, we're going to hear from Maxwell Jacob Freeman. And MGF, he's not too thrilled with management here. I think he wanted to be on Omega Knights with the young talent over there. And he feels like he's stuck with some has-beens over here. So we'll see. All right. Here we go. Comes Rhino.
It is for the Hardcore Championship. Making his way to the ring from Detroit, Michigan. Weighing in at 295 pounds, Ryan O.
Ladies and gentlemen, by night's end, we will crown a new champion.
No offense to you, Cole, but
yes, sir, the master of the gore.
For this match, just so we can hear him say, history has been made at the conclusion.
His opponents, first from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 235 pounds, Raiden.
And here comes Raiden.
Guys, as we look to crown a new champion.
That's right, Cole. We're guaranteed to have a new champion at the end of this one. It's not very often you can say that.
What about Raven? I know he wants this hardcore title. I mean, he is the king of ECW.
And we've seen in the past that he's not afraid to stab somebody in the back to get ahead here in WWE.
I just hope his opposition realizes what he's capable of. If he's willing to deceive those close to him, there's no telling what he'll do to an opponent.
And here comes Rob Van Dam.
And from Battle Creek, Michigan, weighing in at 235 pounds, Rob Van Dam.
The whole effing show.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the vacant championship.
Yes, sir. New Hall of Famer, Rob Van Dam.
Superstars as our next champion. And it's about time, if you ask me.
But I also think it's worth mentioning just how self-centered he's become in recent weeks.
Yeah, and if for whatever reason you don't recognize his greatness, just ask him. I'm sure he can go on for hours about
these ECW legends of this match, man. Makes you believe that. Let's see if they found a replacement.
Byron Saxton, this man is a true testament.
Wait, what is that? Is that? Oh no. Oh no. The Psycho Killer. Tommaso Ciampa. Taking Moxley's spot. Oh man. What a dangerous threat in this match. The former NXT champion after last night's war with Walter coming to the show.
Being loved by the WWE Universe isn't a priority. Ciampa cares about one thing in this world, himself.
And Ciampa also realized that stabbing.
I don't think this is going to set over well with Moxley, but I don't think Tommaso Ciampa cares. The Blackheart himself has made his way to Thursday Night Carnage. The fans were promised a Fatal 4-Way. We're going to give them a Fatal 4-Way. And Rhino exchanging words on the outside.
Absolutely disgusting display by this man when he turned on his best friend, Johnny Gargano. And for what? To become champion? To act like this? Yes. To disgusting WWE.
But here we go.
To the point where they threw you out of the building.
Hey, it comes with the territory.
It's here, Michael. Tommaso Ciampa.
You got a great hardcore title match coming your way. There is the hardcore championship. Don't know why it looks so dark on that screen. But there it is.
There you see what it's all about. Tag team gold.
Yes, sir. Former champions all over the board. Here we go. Raven's looking at it.
There's always one type of match in the WWE.
Looking at Ciampa.
Wilder than wild when things go extreme and the landscape of the WWE changes in unpredictable ways. It's extreme rules.
Absolutely. Oh, here we go. Oh, no, Spike DDT. Oh, and that means DDT on Raven. That's just rude.
For every superstar in this match.
That's a thing, Byron. Many superstars have had their career derailed by...
Uh-oh, submission move. He's just
an armbar
so
in the ring
right now. He's just on. Oh, he breaks free,
but the damage might have already been done, Michael.
Tommaso Ciampa getting a table.
What a clothesline! Ouch! Oh, target acquired and destroyed.
Big open hand strike.
Those palm slaps.
Oh,
oof.
Back suplex.
Is there something to focus on? Who do you think's walking out with the gold?
This career-altering match. It's
you got to accept the fact that you're going to be punished like you've never been punished before, and no mercy will be given.
In this situation,
got Carnage all over this ring.
Unload on your opponent, and a referee's count can't stop you.
You think RVD's walking out?
Ablaze.
Could be.
Got Tommaso Ciampa
taking full advantage. Backbreaker there. Rhino's got a baseball bat. Oh. Oh.
That's the second time.
Taking out Ciampa with a bat. Oh, the jumping knee strike. Rhino just no-sells it. Oh. Oh. Raven taking out Ciampa.
Especially when there are no countouts.
Rob Van Dam's got one of his favorite weapons, the steel chair.
I'm impressed. Whack.
Michael, that gives new meaning to have a seat.
Oof.
Tommaso Ciampa is on the attack now. Tough spot to be in.
All kinds of feuds going on here.
Oh, look at this. Raining right hands. A barrage of strikes. Ciampa looking for the takedown. There it is. Bridging Fujiwara.
Little powerbomb in the ring there by Rhino. It does look like ECW versus Ciampa. Oh. There's that Ciampa submission.
Into an armbar. Submission move locked in. And he breaks the hold. What a striking blow. Put into place. Boom, right to the jaw. You can pick up your team.
Rhino is just no selling Ciampa. But brings him down with the jawbreaker there. Wedging the chair in the corner. Oh, Raven's got the kendo stick.
You got Tommaso Ciampa taking full advantage. There it is.
Did you hear that crack?
Tommaso's leaning the
big elbow.
I know. Oh, low blow by Raven.
Oh, and he lands it. Really relying on that tonight. Harsh impact.
Oh, Raven is taking down Ciampa.
Discus clothesline.
Ciampa's rolling out.
Oh, Corey, he unloaded there.
Oh, Rhino into the chair.
Oh, so ruthless. Now that's how you use a table to your advantage. Elbow right to the back of the neck. Boom, what impact.
Oh, Rob kicks Rhino.
What's coming next?
Ooh, treading all over their opponent.
Uh-oh, armbar.
Uh-oh, submission move.
Being put into knots.
He's just about there. He breaks out.
Ciampa gets out of it.
Yet, Michael.
Ciampa wants a little bit of Raven.
Bringing it back into the ring. He's in a bad spot, guys. I wouldn't be surprised if he hightails it through the crowd. You should go with him, Byron. I don't know how there's anything left in these superstars' bodies.
Yeah, the tank is being emptied.
Ciampa's looking for more toys. Oh, a ladder. We don't need that here. It's not a ladder match.
Rolling Thunder.
There's the pin. Ken is upon a kick out.
He's going for it all. There it is.
Ciampa's going up top. Oh, drop kick.
Saw what he had in mind there. If he breaks the hole, here comes Ciampa. Double underhook apply.
All right, give me a second. I don't know how to do the thing. Okay.
Exiting the ring. Very
Rhino's leaving everybody laying.
Game plan here.
He's got a hammer, more toys.
And Tommaso Ciampa slips out of harm's way. Decks him again. I don't even know how he got up from the first sledgehammer.
Avoiding trouble there.
That is a
yeah, more toys.
Reversal. Jawbreaker!
Call it, Dennis.
Got Tommaso Ciampa taking
Ciampa looking for the takedown. There it is. Bridging Fujiwara.
Cause a tear the features clean off your face.
This could be it. Cover! He lets it go.
Yeah, I wonder why. And he stops the count.
Lucky him.
The roar of this crowd has been building,
Rob.
And they are in a fever pitch right now.
You can feel the anticipation growing.
Uh-oh, stomping away in the corner.
Oh, no. Rob's going coast to coast.
You don't think.
Yes, Blaze Tables.
What on earth is... What are they trying to do?
I think we know exactly what.
Oh, no. Oh, thank you. Oh.
Finds a counter. That's gotta be it. Gets him with a counter.
We're about to see.
He's already spending that winner's purse. You know, we can stay there, guys.
No. Ciampa's trying to take out Rhino after that gore to Rob.
The impact.
Oh, no. Fairy tale ending.
Fairy tale ending.
Is it enough to secure the victory?
Talk about getting knocked into the middle of neck.
Ciampa's walking out with a belt.
Tommaso Ciampa wins.
Well, it wasn't literally fatal, but it was pretty close. Take a look.
Ciampa steals one. Ciampa wasn't even supposed to be in this match. It was supposed to be John Moxley. I can't believe it. He just walked in and took the belt on the opening night of Thursday Night Carnage. Looks like a he's got a new Goldie. And Raven just woke up in time to realize what was happening. It was too late.
Here is your winner,
I know, man. Tough loss to ECW.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's a very big
Choppy. Choppa's got everything he needs. He's got his gold. I don't think he's letting that go anytime soon. Thank you. Thank you, Pesto. It'll be interesting to see who's going to be the man to try to take that from Ciampa. Thank you, Omega. All right. So coming up next, we're going to hear from Maxwell Jacob Freeman. So we're literally halfway through this card already. How are we doing? Thank you. All right. So coming up next, it's Maxwell Jacob Freeman, MJF. Yes, sir. Thank you, Pesto. And then after this match, we're going to have a six-pack challenge for the North American Championship, I do believe. No, I'm wrong. It is. We're going to see Rey Mysterio in action next. My bad. Rey Mysterio's in action after this promo. All right. Tommaso, or MJF's already in the ring. So, he's been livid all week. All right, listen up, you idiots.
Starts with a bang.
All right, hold on. It's showing me these things. All right, listen up, idiots. All right. I didn't even want to be on the show. I wanted to be on Omega Nights where all the young kids are. And then not only do I get drafted on this pathetic show, the stupid idiot in charge didn't even draft my war dog, Wardlow. So, with that being said, I need some help around here and find me a new war dog. That's the British Bulldog.
This crowd obviously wants to know what's going on.
The British Bulldog is on Thursday Night Carnage? All right.
Could be a formidable team in the making.
All right, listen up, kid.
Well, the table is set.
I don't plan on being anybody's bitch, but I'll be your war dog as long as I can get my hands on that filthy Hart family, Owen Hart and Bret Hart. I'm the real star of this family. I'm going to be the top guy of this family. I'm the head of the table here. Just like Roman Reigns is the head of the table on the B show.
Bad blood is a boiling.
And
the belief is strong.
Max says, you know, as long as we're on the same page and you're willing to be on my war dog, how about we both get what we want? I get some gold. You get to take out the Hart family. And everything's going to be A-okay. Because honestly, we're better than you. And you know it.
The fans are eating it up.
Yeah, those armbands are very out there.
Seems to be a lot of anger behind those words. We might be seeing a new.
So we got a new alliance form in here. These two are going to be quite the tandem here. British Bulldog as MJF's muscle on this show. And I think there's a world title tournament next week for the number one contender spot, but MJF's not on it. So I don't know how he's going to get to the gold, but he's going to have a mountain to climb. Let's see how they do it. Roman is obviously in charge of that show.
Did anyone else get that?
What? Is it over? I must have fallen asleep for a second there.
Man, what a mess.
All right. So British Bulldog and MJF working together. All right, so Rey Mysterio is in action coming up next. It's going to be interesting to find out Rey Mysterio's place on this card. There's a lot of top guys on the show. And we still have three more matches after this one for you, including a six-pack challenge and the big main event, the big triple threat for the World Heavyweight Championship. Hey, all right, let me get that music ready. Yeah, brought that old music back. Greatest cruiserweight there ever was, Rey Mysterio Jr.
Being in the presence of a true legend of Lucha Libre gives the arena a total electric feeling. It's indescribable.
Rey Mysterio is undoubtedly one of the all-time greats and potentially a future Hall of Fame.
And who's his opponent tonight? I know that music, and that can only mean one man. That's got to be the Rainmaker, Kazuchika Okada. And I know this man wants to be a world champion on this show, and he's got another hill to climb. He is in that world title tournament next week if he can beat Rey Mysterio. Otherwise, Rey Mysterio is going to get that spot. And the two losers of tonight's main event will be in that spot, and then there'll be one other man yet to be determined.
Some of the most intense competitors in all of WWE.
The Rainmaker is here on Thursday Night Carnage. And if you don't know about the Rainmaker and Okada, he was the world champion for like 2 years over in New Japan, until he was finally defeated by Kenny Omega in a one-hour match. It was insane. Highly recommend watching that series, too.
I'd like to point out just how focused these guys look here tonight.
They really do, Michael, which makes me think we're in for one heck of a match here tonight.
So here we go, Okada versus Rey Mysterio Jr.
Rey Mysterio continues his journey in WWE.
Oh, Okada's already throwing around Rey.
Chasing his dreams and taking on all comers, even when the odds in inches are stacked against him.
Okada doesn't seem impressed by Rey.
This is the match Milwaukee has been waiting for, and I'm sure it won't disappoint.
We are seeing a lot of guts, a lot of determination out there. You have to wonder where that one turning point
Oh, incredible combo. We're at a vital stage in this matchup, and this audience is fully aware of it. Yeah, they know another turning point can come at any second.
Oh, Rey reverses. It's behind Okada.
He's in control.
Hurricanrana.
Oh, wow.
Frankensteiner.
Nice.
Here we go. Oh, nice forearm strike by Rey Rey.
Smash. Boom, what a forearm.
Rey's taking over this match.
Scissors. I don't know what he has planned out here, but he must be mindful of the referee's count.
Oh.
Two.
Rey took a bad bump there on the out on the rail. Another backbreaker. Backdrop.
Nasty attack to the neck. He's not looking good here, guys.
Stretching out Rey a little bit.
Oh, look at this aggression in the corner.
Yeah.
Boot right in the jaw.
Oh, running knee strike to Rey Rey.
He's feeling the effects of that last hit. He planned for this and could still rally. Rey Mysterio has grown accustomed to not having the obvious advantage in the ring. How can he work past an imposing opponent? That's very simple.
uses speed. There are few in the WWE who can keep up with Ray when he really gets going up. He
wasted DDT no time going for the pin. One. No, and kicks out at one.
Ray Mysterio. Clearly not enough damage done.
What's he got in mind?
Oh, powerbomb of Ray Ray. Wow. Oh, another powerbomb, the sunset flip. It's a back and forth match here.
Too quick to catch him there. Oh, red of there.
Two. Oh, into the rail again.
Three. Back in from the
floor. Gotta get him back into the ring. Oh, nice counter by Ray.
Mysterio creating opportunity.
Delivered.
Didn't get all of that clothesline, but Okada is taking charge of this match. Oh, Ray counters back and forth. Here we go.
Yet another
counter. Oh, another jumping DDT.
Somehow one step ahead of each other.
Oh, into the side of the ring, drop kick.
Anticipated that attack. Perfectly.
Back and forth between Ray and Okada.
How impressive was that reversal?
Back suplex. He's absorbing some tough hits now. He's getting beaten up out there, but staying strong.
Four. Five. Give me a second. Sorry, everybody. There you go. Oh. All right. Back and forth. Had a distraction. Apologies. Back into the ring they go.
Brought in the hard way.
Oh, man. He's going for that neck breaker. Here we go. Is that going to be enough to beat Rey Mysterio?
We've got a cover.
One, two, no, he kicks out.
Yeah, it's gonna take more than that to keep him down.
He's gonna try again. I don't think he believes it. And he kicks out at one this time.
Too soon. Just caught flush.
Ray's trying to get back into this match. I just don't know if he can do it. Come on, Ray.
I'll break your crown. Gentlemen, Ray Mysterio may be fading away here. He can't recover from a beating like this. He is efficient and dangerous with his offense thus far.
His offense is second to none at times like this.
Setting him up for the flatline.
Oh, Ray's getting back into this match. Oh no, wrist lock. Hurricane Rana. Sunset flip bomb. Ray's fighting back.
All the way up and down.
Oh, here we go, Hurricane Rana. Oh, but Okada catches him.
He's one step ahead there. Great technical know-how.
Oh, and he rolled out before he calls for the Rainmaker.
Overhand right lands. Bad spot for him to be in here, guys.
Oh, no. What's he going for here? Oh, he's going for running dive. Oh, the flip to the outside. Just back and forth match.
That's worth another look.
What What a flip by Okada. And he's going for the Nightbreaker. Oh, a very fast one that time. Ray, you gotta be careful. Looks like Okada's done. He's calling for the Rainmaker.
And you know what,
oh, spinning back fist. Rainmaker!
Clothesline. Ouch. That's his go-to move. Can he finish this?
One, two. Oh, Ray kicks out. Ray kicks out of the Rainmaker. Holy shit. Holy shit, he just kicked out of the Rainmaker.
And Rey Mysterio says, not this time. Showing some quickness. This match can change.
Quick clothesline.
Oh, here we go. DDT.
DDT. One. Two. Oh, two count.
Yeah, but he's hurt, guys.
He's going up top.
He's looking to fly. From the top.
Oh, axe handle.
Double axe handle. What a punch. Ooh. What a punch. That's how you stop your opponent.
All those jabs. And then he's going back for the neck breaker one more time.
Neck breaker. That could be it. There's the pin.
One. Two, and he kicks out again. He kicks out one more time. Oh my God, what a match. Okada's picking him up. I think he's just tired of the... What is this? German suplex. Oh, no, 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 ripcord. Rainmaker! One. Two, three. What a match between Okada and Rey Mysterio. I don't know if that'll be the last between those two. That was a great contest, back and forth. Big futures between both men. Rey just kicked out of so much, including a Rainmaker. But he was not able to execute the 619. And Okada just was too much for him in the end. Too much size, too much strength. But a hell of a contest from Rey Mysterio Jr. And Okada will be in that world title No More Contenders tournament next week.
Here is your winner, China. That's an impressive win right there.
What a match.
And you're not feeling good about
what
yourself
a match.
After a win like that, you better get yourself checked. Guys, it sounds like we can all agree that was an extremely impressive win.
All right, we are at the halfway point for sure. We only have a few more contests left. The next match is a six-pack challenge for the North America Championship, which includes Cody Rhodes, Owen Hart, Adam Hangman Page, Kenny Omega, Kyle O'Reilly, and a mystery participant. I honestly don't know who's going to walk out with this one. It honestly could be anybody. and it's for the North American Championship. I think it's going to be good. I think it's going to be really good. And, of course, coming up after this match, you're going to see Kota Ibushi in action. He was supposed to... Nah. Go. All right. So here we go. Six-pack challenge. About to get underway. How are we doing so far, though? Y'all hanging in there? Having a good time? Hell yeah. And the rules of the six-pack challenge, it's first to pinfall wins the match. Pinfall or submission. It's taking a minute to load everybody in. And we broke the game. So hold on just a second, y'all. Let me restart it up. All right, let me restart it and get us back to where we were. Of course, the game froze. That's 2K20. I was just thinking how good it was doing so far. We're down to our final three matches, too. So we're, like, right there. Okay, cool. It kept where we were. All right. Sorry, y'all. That's what 2K20 does. Especially when you got a bunch of creative people. So I think Kyle O'Reilly is the only normie in the match. And of course, we got a mystery participant in this match that gets a challenge for the North American Championship. And this could be anybody's ball game here. First to a finish. Hey, we're supposed to get an announcement for 2K to, on Sunday. For the next game, I guess. Yeah, they announced that earlier today. They're going to do an announcement during WrestleMania. And then also on Sunday, we got that Jericho interview with Stone Cold Steve Austin. So that should be really good. Come on, load this match. do. Again? All right, so apparently six or five created characters on one match just breaks the game. Oh, thank you. Yeah, it's just back and it's back. All right, so I'm gonna try this one more time, and then if that doesn't work, we may just hit the simit, which is unfortunate. That would be really unfortunate if we have to do that. All right, 2K. Be good to me. I'm not even going to play this time. I'm just going to let it play the match. I was going to play it, but I'm going to let the computer do it this time. I would hate to have to sim this match. I really would. But apparently six breaks the game. You would think. But Apesto has this problem every time he does the Royal Rumble to you, so... The thing's still spinning. Hi, Anne. How are you? We're having technical issues with this game because this game is broken. But we're trying. Yay! Still spinning. If this match does get simmed, I'll find a way to make up for it. Yeah, there it goes. It messed up again. So we're going to sim that, unfortunately. So I lost a match in the card. All right, so what's it doing? There it goes. All right, so this match was supposed to debut Dean Malenko. He's one of my surprise draft picks. Unfortunately, this match was not able to happen, so I'm going to find a way to fix that next week where maybe they can't have this many people, but we can see Dean Malenko wrestle next week and get his fair shake at the title. Maybe he walks out champion here. I don't know. But unfortunately, we do get to sim this match because otherwise we can't go forward with the card. All right. So I'll let y'all watch this with me. We'll see how it goes. All right, and your new North American champion is? Kenny Omega. Nice. So Kenny Omega is the champ. And now we get to see the giant go one-on-one with Kota Ibushi. Since I was going to make that a surprise for the Giant, but we're going to make up for it a little bit because that sucks. I hate that for you guys. All right, so also next week, the losers of tonight's main event, the two losers, will be in a tournament with Okada and now the North American champion, Kenny Omega. And the winner will go on of this tournament will go on to fight at McCracken Mayhem for the Twitch World Champion against the winner of tonight's main event. And this is Kota Ibushi, the former IWGP Heavyweight Champion, who was just recently defeated by Will Ospreay in Japan. Not yet, buddy. Not yet. We got two more matches. We got stalled by a 2K issue.
Guys, this match is sure to not disappoint, especially considering who's involved here tonight.
You're absolutely right, Michael. This match will be one we'll be talking about for a long time to come.
I have to say, the level of pride he has in his game is truly impressive, guys.
Yeah, he's about as proud as a peacock, Michael. And you know what? He has every right to be.
That's the Big Show's music. It's the Big Show's Titantron. But this isn't the Big Show. No more BS here. No, no, no. This is the Giant.
And his opponent from New York, weighing in at 403 pounds, the Giant.
There is an absolutely big fight feel in the arena.
7 foot tall, 500 pounds. A weapon of mass destruction. He definitely outsizes Ibushi. It's not even close.
To agree with that statement, Cole. I mean, just look at him. I'll tell you, he's going to be tough to beat, that's for sure.
So here we go. The Giant versus Kota Ibushi.
It's go time, fellas. It's hard to pick a winner for this one.
Height of your ex, which is insane height. Yeah, he's a very big guy.
That'll leave a mark.
Kota just, he is outsized, outmatched.
When Monday Night Raw comes to your town, do us
backbreaker, and then just slings him across the ring.
Television show in history.
And then, of course, up next is the big main event that we've been talking about all week.
Lariat.
Oh, Poor Kota. No, Kota's going to fight back.
He's not looking so hot here, guys. And momentum is certainly not on his side right now.
Oh, nice little kick. Oof. And a headbutt.
What a headbutt. Vicious.
Kota's trying. He just out being outweighed. Oh, he got him on the ground. He got him on the ground.
That kick will stop you in your tracks.
Don't touch me.
The damage he's taking is starting to pile up. He had to be prepared to take some damage tonight.
Oh, it's a rest move. We're not doing rest moves.
Oh, the old neck crank.
You'll feel that tomorrow morning.
Oh, man.
A striking blow. Definitely not where you want to be right now. Ooh, right to the throat.
Just, oh, he's laying out Ibushi here.
First one missed, second one didn't. Effective.
Oh, German suplex.
German suplex.
Well, that was shoulders. Impressive by Ibushi. He picked him up.
Big move coming. This is how people end up getting hurt.
Oh, just jackknifed him. Just running hip.
What impact?
Oh, another hip attack.
He's getting pushed out into the defensive.
Yeah, he's looking off his game now.
Striking blow. He is efficient and dangerous with his offense thus far.
He's in non-stop attack mode.
Another jackknife.
Power bomb.
Pulls him back into the ring.
In the hard way.
I think Big Show's getting ready to put Ibushi away.
Great competitors. Great superstars right here in
WWE. The big leg drop there.
Shoulders down, is it enough? One, two.
And how Ibushi kicks out.
That is anyone's guess.
He's going to continue to fight, but I don't think he's got a chance here.
Here it comes, he's got him.
The Giants lining up for that choke slam. I think this is going to be it. I don't think Ibushi's got a chance.
He's going to... Here it comes! Choke slam!
That is a big choke slam in the middle of the ring. One, two. Oh, he kicked out!
How does he keep doing this?
Still in it.
He kicked out.
Performance.
I can't believe Kota kicked out of the choke slam.
Relentless. Enough already.
I think it's going to hurt him more than help him.
Attack on the back. Kick right to the midsection. This is a tough spot to find yourself in, that's for sure. Jackknife powerbomb.
Another jackknife.
Showing some quickness. And this match can change
caught the super kick.
He evades the attack.
Just, he can't do anything on offense. He's trying. Bushi's trying so hard.
Saw what he had in mind there.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Good fight. See ya.
Choke slam. He can end it here. He's got him.
One, two, three. Good fight by Ibushi. All right, y'all. You know what that means. That match is over. So the main event's coming up next. This is the giant Pesto, the giant Paul White. I just don't know what the Giant wants on this show, but whatever he wants, I don't see much that's going to stop him. All right, y'all. It is time for the main event of the evening between Kurt Angle, Shawn Michaels, and Bret Hart for the Twitch World Heavyweight Championship. I know on the poll on Twitter, Shawn Michaels won, but Kurt Angle came in second. No one thinks Bret Hart's going to win this match. Bret Hart is the overwhelming underdog in this match, but this could go either way, honestly. It's going to be a hell of a match. Two technical studs, the greatest to ever do it in Shawn Michaels. This is going to be an amazing match. The Canadian GOAT, Bret Hart. Yeah, no one picked him. No one thinks he's going to win. This should be, man. I think this is going to be a banger for the World Heavyweight Championship. And here we go. Oh, crap, wrong guy. Sean's coming out first. Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. Yes, sir. So good at this. Excellence of execution, Bret the Hitman Hart. From Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing in at 235 pounds, Bret the Hitman Hart. Or as Token calls him, the Canadian GOAT.
The arrival of the excellence of execution, his pure wrestling ability and talent, Bret Hart may be unmatched. Get ready for a clinic. I can't wait to see what this match has in store for us. Ooh, I'm getting goosebumps just thinking about it.
Very big match feels. I got that metal Kurt Angle music coming out for the wrestling machine, the Olympic hero, Kurt Angle.
The impact he's made as the general manager of the flagship show of WWE.
big match feels here. In this big main event match, this is anybody's ball game here. Here we go. Here we go. The crowd's saying you still got it.
Tag team championship.
Here we go. The World Twitch Championship. Shawn Michaels, Bret Hart, Kurt Angle.
Here we go with this huge triple threat match.
Oh, God. Immediately throws Shawn across the ring. Oh, Brett. Brett's going after Shawn also.
Anything left in these superstars' bodies. Yeah, the tank is being emptied tonight. Oh, Corey, he unloaded there.
Oh.
A European uppercut. Kurt Angle exploiting the opening.
And, oh, neck breaker.
Neck breaker. Picture perfect. Bang right in the face. Bret Hart with a nice reversal.
Oh, suplex.
Tossed with the suplex.
Bret's going for the pin already.
And he stops the count. Lucky him.
Kurt just picked up Bret, or picked up Shawn and walked away.
Is he going to do it? Oh, shoulder breaker. Out of it in the corner. Reverses. Can he make him pay? Wow, what a sequence.
Back and forth. Here we go.
Ooh, bullseye. In a matchup like this, Corey, what is something the competitors need to remember?
Well, a major difference in a triple threat is that you can lose a match without being part of the decision.
It's like Bret and can be Kurt automatically getting a little
that's why
into it.
In this match, a competitor must be cunning, calculated, and move with silent speed.
Oof.
Driven down face first. Drop kick.
Great athleticism.
Bret's taking over this match.
And he's out of there in a nick of time. In control here with a swinging neck breaker.
Textbook.
And there's a backbreaker to Bret Hart.
Oh, and a backbreaker.
Right to the spine.
Suplex to the inside.
All on the apron, lifting it up into the ring. Bam, suplex. In the face.
An early pin attempt.
One. Oh, one count.
Gonna take a whole lot more.
Oof.
Side Russian,
the Russian leg sweep here.
We've got a cover.
Sean's trying to put Bret away. Bret's not having any of it.
Pinfall at this point, and the Hart family legend continues to grow.
Oof. Going for the leg. Throwing some punches.
Punch after punch after punch. Oh, nasty fall. Shawn, here we go.
Oh, he overshot Bret Hart. Gonna try again.
From the top.
Oh, just the, in between both of them.
Back now inside the ring.
Shawn has not made friends. Sleeper hold to Kurt Angle.
Byron's got the sleeper locked in. The sleeper hold is locked in. This could be it.
Oh, jawbreaker.
Great job breaking the hold there.
Good thing too. That could have been ugly, Michael.
Toss
pass to the outside.
That's a suplex.
Textbook vertical suplex. Bam.
This is going to be big.
Oh, elbow drop to the outside.
Elbow drop.
Oh, no. Here we go. He's tuning up the band.
He's tuning up the band.
Here we go. How about a little?
Oh, sweet chin music.
Here he goes for the win. Can he close it out? One, two.
And Kurt kinks out at two.
We're seeing here.
Sean must have not got all of it.
Bang right in the face.
Woo-wee.
Forearm kick.
I thought he had it too. Oh, big suplex in the middle of the ring. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, the sharpshooter. The sharpshooter. Oh, come on, Brett. No, come on, Kurt. Come on, Kurt. No! Brett tapped out Kurt Angle. Bret Hart tapped out Kurt Angle. He was the underdog favorite here. No one picked him to win. And he just tapped out Kurt Angle. I guess the sweet chin music and the sharpshooter was just too much for Kurt. Your new world heavyweight champion. And looks like Kurt and Shawn Michaels will be at the world title tournament next week with Okada and Kenny Omega. And that's our show, folks. Bret Hart, the new champion. The new champion. No one picked him to do it, and he just stole it. Canada wins again, y'all. And that's the show. Hell of a first show. And don't forget Monday night, we have Omega Nights. Pesto's coming back next week. Big things coming out. We'll be back next Thursday for another round of this. Yes, sir. All right. So with that being said, anything you guys want to talk about? Like any matches in particular? Because if not, we're going to go ahead and find somebody to raid. And I'll be back on later on playing with Llama and Jellyfish. Hey, you know how it goes, man. They're good. I don't have it to where I could send it out. I'll read it out real quick. All right. So we have Shawn Michaels, Kurt Angle, Bret Hart, Jon Moxley, Kenny Omega, Rey Mysterio, Kane, Cody Rhodes, Tommaso Ciampa, RVD, Raven, we have FTR, Rhino, Big Show, Hangman Adam Page, MJF, Shelton Benjamin, Okada, Kyle O'Reilly, Bobby Roode, Kota Ibushi, Lance Storm, Charlie Haas, the British Bulldog, and Dean Malenko. That is the roster. And of course, next week we're going to see the world title tournament happen. Either MJF or his War Dog will be in action. I'm not sure which, but it should be good. Hey, that's what's up, T-Flint. We're actually just wrapping up. We're getting ready to raid somebody. I need to do that. I do need to do that. I just haven't gotten around to it. And that way I can show it. But we had two solid shows this week between... It's not working yet, and I got to fix it. The browser says it's not working. I've tried. We had a good show with Omega Knights on Monday. Solid show. And we had another solid show here tonight. Is Pesto Vibes coming back next week? I know his first thing is on the 12th. I need to do my commands, Omega. I need to set those up. I haven't done that yet. I need to get around to it. I'll probably work on that here in just a second, actually. Well, after our raid. So we got a bunch of big stuff coming on. So let's find somebody to raid. Who do we want to raid? At 8, what day? Yo, what's up, Green? How you doing? Because, Pesto, I'm only... Oh, on Monday, I'll be at work until 10 Central Time. My off days are Thursday and Friday. Okay. Hell yeah. That's what's up. All right, so I'll tune in for that at work, but I won't be able... Like, I won't be on my computer. I'll just be in there spotty. Let's see who's live right now. All right. All right. Rue is back tonight, so we're going to raid Rue. I think that's the goal. That's what I want to do. We haven't seen Rue in a long time. Yep. All right. So 9 p.m. Eastern is Omega Knights. All right. Oh, thank you for the biddies, Anne. You're so sweet. All right, so let's go ahead and get ready to raid Rue. Let's show them some, show her some cleanup crew love. Somebody wants to type something up until I get emojis. We're gonna be working on that here soon. I need to get with Llama. Help me out here. All right, so let's go ahead and get ready for that raid. So here we go, guys. Let's go give her some love.
Surprisingly slept more consistently last night than I had in a while. I woke up an hour and a half ago. Good night, JoJo, Daddy, bro. I'm sorry to call him. Oh, raid!
Hey.
I was about to say welcome, Shadow, but you changed your name. Welcome, Mr. Clean. Welcome,
Mr. Clean.
I'm so used to his other name. Like, he recently rebranded to Mr. Clean Gaming. Hey, guys. How'd the stream go? Shout out over here.
Oh, I could have shouted out too.
You can. You're slacking.
I was too busy laughing at the hashtag cleanup crew.
Yeah, like he completely rebranded. I guess that's part of his rebranding. I thought it was tons of fun. What'd you guys do? What were you playing? Oh, dang, I was typing that SF. yourself faster. I beat all my mods to the show.
The alpha mod has arrived.
No, thanks for the raid. What were you up to? I need to stop nitpicking this door. This door really is not important. My big wrestling show, I'll be doing weekly WWE 2K20. Nice, nice. I'll redeem the hey you to you, Rue. Hello, Ann. Hello. Hey you to Ann. Welcome, welcome. What's up with the hand reveal? Yeah, apes can vouch. There was a hand reveal. Super epic hand reveal.
There was indeed.